Ooga shaka, ooga, ooga, ooga shaka, ooga, ooga. I can't stop this feeling.
Ah, I'm hooked on a feeling.
I'm high on believing. Suki, you ready to start the program?
Let's do it in 3, 2, 1.
The Suki and Scott Show.
It's musical. It's magical.
You guys, I nailed it. You're great. You have great questions. You listen.
You guys have such amazing energy.
The Suki and Scott Show.
What's up? What's up? Good looking. How are you?
Didn't get it, Sook. I'm just not fast enough with that 30-second intro. Sook, what's going on, babe?
So today, if you are joining us from the East Coast, New York, New Jersey, we're all digging out over here. We had a serious storm. I mean, it was ridiculous. Look at you.
Sook, that's my backyard right now.
I mean, so you had about 2 feet of snow, you're saying?
2 feet of snow, Sook. It never stopped coming. It's still flurrying now.
I know, I know, I know. We had about 18 inches. Hey, now.
Hey, that's what she said. listen, another exciting week ahead. Little programming note. Tomorrow night, we won't be on, but we'll be back Thursday night with comedian Bill Engvall. And one of our funniest singers, YX, remember the guy, baby, let's have sex tonight. He's coming on live. I'll show you him in a little while.
I love you just singing that song. Like,
baby,
what?
Let's have sex tonight. Sex
okay, tonight. Scott. All right. That sounds good. How's everybody doing? It's been a minute. Look at Carol Goodrich joining us, Pamela Noseda, Jesse Flowers, Jennifer Stoddard, Mary Zigga, Rory Wright, Anna Hoover, Betty Mann, Ann Engelbrecht. Nice to see you, Donna Frischato. Everybody's saying hello.
Yeah.
Some new names on here, too.
What a show we have tonight, Suki. Coming up in about 7-8 minutes. The foremost movie/film critic in the entire country. Of course, we're talking about the legendary Jeffrey Lyons, who was just a staple here in New York and, of course, across America. And also Tony Hill is a fitness guru/music. Sook, wait till you hear Tony Hill's
voice. Music.
The guy's jacked like you wouldn't believe, and he sings like an angel. He's going to give us some pointers. He's going to sing for us. Phil's going to be by later on. He's going to sing. We got the weatherman with his forecast coming up. And we also have
a special gift for our friends.
Yes,
right?
we've got a new product that Suki and I just absolutely love. Show them, Suki, a little Yobo right here. We're going to tell you guys about this in just a few minutes.
I got a pink one.
You got a nice. Oh, you got a pink one, Suki? Mm-hmm. I got a blue one.
Yeah, you can make it towards anybody's taste. We'll tell you what it is. It looks like it looks like a tool, but let me tell you, it's a little bit more, ladies and gentlemen.
Just in time for Valentine's Day. this is one of the greatest massage power tools I've ever seen, and we're going to tell you guys.
I was looking at you before, and I'm like, Scotty, don't talk to me. I was like,
she was like, oh, this is great. Anyway, we're going to tell you how you guys can get one. With free shipping, Suki and I have our own promo code. It's going to be amazing. Suki, you know why I'm most excited, though?
What are you excited about?
Suki, you know how the mail, the postal service, their motto is, you know, rain, sleet, snow, hail. They don't stop. Well, you see the Slapshot poster in the back? Jeffrey Lyons will appreciate this. This Slapshot movie poster starring Paul Newman. This thing arrived yesterday, Suki, right in the middle of the snowstorm. I've been waiting for it for 6 weeks for a lousy poster.
In the snowstorm?
In the snowstorm, the guy shows up with the thing, with, you know, the poster with the thing, the cardboard. And sure enough, they brought it, and I got a new poster for behind me. A little slap. I know you've never seen Slapshot, probably, but it's
a hockey movie. Like, it's a kid hockey movie, right?
Yeah. Great sports movie. I didn't see
Bad News Bears. Does that count?
That's not a bad movie with Walter Matthau, of course. But you know what song is in Slapshot? They're riding on the bus to one of their hockey games. And I think if love is good, love can be strong, we gotta get right back to
where we started from.
Love is good, love can be strong. I think that's the Hughes Corporation that sings that song.
Oh, is it? But, is it? Listen, everybody's talking about the snow. All of our thread, I think, looks like snow up and down. Everybody.
It was unbelievable. I took my snowblower 3 times yesterday. And when I went out this morning, it was like I never even touched the stuff.
Because it's drifting. It's terrible. It's terrible.
But
you know, when a lot of people are, you know, like we're dealing with our parents and we can't get out of our house, but our parents, I'm calling friends. I'm doing favors on Staten Island. I'm like, Joey, AJ, can you go to my parents' house and do something? I mean, seriously, I was making calls like it was like a deal or something. All right, I'll hook you up next time.
I'll owe you a favor next time. You take care
exactly.
of
exactly. So shout out to AJ and Victor Zambrano digging my parents, shoveling them out. Really appreciate you. But that's the whole part about it that we love. During snowstorms like this, you got to help in. You got to pitch in and help your neighbors whenever necessary.
Duke, you know what? When I'm out there doing my snow, I'm like, I see my neighbors across the street and they're shoveling. I'm like, oh God, I gotta help these people.
You
gotta
help them.
And I'm physically just drained. I'm like, oh man.
But your conscience, you were raised properly. Your conscience wouldn't let you stop it and go back in like you never saw them before. Like you see the elderly couple, you're not like running away, like, I don't think Mr. Cohen saw me.
It reminded me of when I was a kid charging $25, you know, a driveway back in the old days. It used to be a lot of fun.
Listen, the Hughes Corporation saying rock the boat.
All right. Rock the boat. So what?
Thank you. And Engelbrecht.
It's something family, I think, then. It's called
We Are Family.
No, the name of the group is the Something Family.
Sly and the Family Stone?
No, we got it. Somebody looked that up for me on one of our audience members. Just look up. We got to get right back to where we started. It's back to where we started.
And Engelbrecht said, I think it's Maxine Nightingale saying right back where we started.
That's it. Maxine Nightingale. I wasn't even close. Yes, Maxine Nightingale. But it's great. Paul Newman. They're hanging out the window of the bus. And it's such a guy's, you know, just stupidity. And it's just, you know, there's a lot of crude humor in it. And it's such a great movie. But we'll talk about some movies when Jeffrey comes.
Can I watch it with my kids?
No, you definitely don't want to watch it with your kids. There's actually a part where Paul Newman is standing in front of the goalie from the other team. And he's like, hey, Pierre. I slept with your wife last night. And the guy gets crazy and they scored a goal on him because he's going nuts. But you don't want to watch it with your kids. Jeffrey's going to give us, you know, we're going to talk movies with him. He's going to give us like his top 10 favorite movies of all time.
That's great.
And you know what I did, Souk? That, you know that game you played with Phil last week with the movie
game?
I love that one.
Yeah,
I figured we can't have Jeffrey Lyons on and not play that game with him.
Absolutely.
So I got a whole new slew of movies where they're just pictures where you and he'll play together. It's going to be great. So we'll
game on. I love it. Some people are asking about Will Presti, saying, where's Willie Boy been?
You know,
he's
funny
Presti,
you
he's going to come back on.
I just spoke to Will. Will's coming on Thursday.
Okay,
he
great.
He said he's got a lot of good takes. So it's good. So Thursday show, because we're not on tomorrow night, programming note. Bill Engvall, incredible comedian, world famous comedian. A guy by the name of YX, who's that singer that I was telling. Let me show you who he is, Souk. Remember, then we'll bring. Okay. Then we'll bring.
I remember
Jeffrey.
Him. He made me laugh.
Here's the guy. Had all those songs. His girlfriend or his wife? I don't even know. She was like, dude, just leave me alone. So here's one of the songs from YX. He'll be on with us on Thursday.
Play it.
I was ready. She said all she had to do was change her clothes, powder her nose. Sun is setting as I look at the window, and at this rate she's moving at, I don't think I'll ever go. Sing it with me. When will she be ready? When will she be ready? When will she be ready? Oh, I don't know.
So, he does it so beautifully. Like,
baby,
like,
let's have sex tonight. He's like, baby, you mad at me, babe? Right. Sook, you would have thought, I thought he was just like a viral, you know, TikTok guy. He's got a whole management team behind him.
Definitely.
It's unbelievable. But yeah, so he'll be on Thursday. Will Presti going to be on Thursday? We won't be on tomorrow night, taking a little break. Sook, are you ready for Mr. Jeffrey Lyons?
Always. Been ready. Right,
ladies and gentlemen, this man, he's a film critic. He's an author. He's a tremendous sports fan. I'm going to take you back to 1986, Sook, before we bring Jeffrey in. He's either going to love this or be mortified by it.
That you have it?
1986. Take a look.
Now it's time for our Friday night movie. Tonight, INN film critic Jeffrey Lyons reviews Short Circuit. Jeffrey?
Mort, I will not pull the wool over your eyes. When the director of Saturday Night Fever and War Games, John Batta, makes a movie, I'm interested. After all, I picked War Games as one of the best films of the year when it was released. Too bad his latest, however, Short Circuit, which opens today everywhere, quickly lets you down. For this is just an infantile version of E.T. Splash with a little bit of Starman mixed in. You know, lovable alien comes on the scene and quickly learns our pop culture, of course, by watching television.
So, by the way, Short Circuit with our buddy Steve Guttenberg, who's coming on the following week. So we won't play that for him. But here he is, Jeffrey Lyons. Welcome, my friend.
This is the great Morton Boone I was working with. Another big Red Sox fan as I am. So great privilege to work with him.
Yeah. No, that was INN News. What was that? Was that local?
Channel 9?
That was Channel 11's national feed. They fed that to independent stations.
Oh, okay. 11. Fix 11. Yeah, we know that station.
We know that station.
No, I worked with Morton Dean. I worked at WPIX from 1970 to 1991. And by that time, I'd also gotten the job at PBS co-hosting Sneak Previews. Did that till 1996. And then I joined WNBC. So my TV career has been in three different stages.
Wow.
Incredible, Jeffrey. Incredible. Scott and I, we've had the pleasure of interviewing you on TV, your books, and it's just been such an illustrious career. How have you been doing? What's going on during this time?
Coming out in May 1st. One is the all-time Boston Red Sox book. They asked me to pick the best players at each position with honorable mentions, and I used 200 or 300 of my Red Sox collections. There it is, Theodore Samuel Williams on the cover. I used all my baseball cards as photos instead of, you know, purchased photos. And so far, I've got a nice blurb from Bob Costas and from Jim Cott, one of the great non-Hall of Famers who belongs on the 16 Gold Gloves, 283 wins, and working on some other blurbs. And the other book is called Hemingway and Me, about my family's friendship with Ernest Hemingway. We were his guests in Cuba when I was a child.
Wow. Hemingway.
Yeah. Wow. And when Mary found the body before she called the authorities, she called my father to tell the world that he was dead. And I found a collection of letters between them. And we went back to Cuba with Red Sox announcer Joe Castiglione and his wife. And we went back to we went back to the forum where I was as a child. And I donated the letters. And they asked me to come back in June of 2017 to lecture at the Hemingway Colloquium. And I decided to make a book out of that because it changed my life. I've been to Spain 36 times since then and spent 7 summers with Spain's greatest matador, who was Hemingway's godson. So,
I was going to ask you about that, Jeff. You studied bullfighting?
I did. And my friend Antonio Ordonez goes to bullfighting, what Willie Mays, Ted Williams, Stan Musial, Mickey Mantle, were to baseball. And in 1961, when I was 15, Hemingway thought it would be right before he died. He thought it would be a week or two, turned into 7 summers. We became brothers from other mothers. And I've been all over Spain, and I can't defend it. And everybody who attacks it here is absolutely right, but I hope I've never gone hunting or fishing or horse racing. So we have our own, but it's part of Spain's culture. and I've seen almost every part of Spain. We go 2,000 miles a week by car up and down Spain.
Wow.
Yeah, and I would pick up the baseball games back home and try to explain them. When I met Louis Tion for the first time, I said, I heard your first game traveling in a limousine at 45 miles an hour with six Spanish bullfighters, and I had to explain to them what a foul ball was and what a sacrifice fly was. He loved it. And he remembered the game, too, of course.
Incredible. Incredible. So you spent time in summers in Malaga, Spain, I see, huh?
Yeah. All over Spain, yeah. We would see Spain during the summer, a normal summer, has different ferias, different festivals, and the bullfighters go from city to city. And that's what we would do. And you travel all night, and back in those days, you wouldn't see another car all night. You make a pit stop in a restaurant, and there was inevitably a life-size portrait of the maestro, and I'm sure he comped us all for dinners, and then you get back in the car, and you arrive in the city in the morning, and you go to the hotel. Then you go down to the corrals to look at the bulls, what the matador is going to face that day, and then you come back, and you're always living out of the bag, because if he did a bad job, boom, you're out of town the next day. But if he triumphed, well, you get all the phone calls, and everybody. And he was
but
great.
That's the same regardless of what country you're in. If you do well, you're applauded.
Right.
If you're not, Henry, you
got to a dangerous summer about him and his brother-in-law, Dominguín, about the summer of 1959, wow. Right before I came on the scene. So it's a great time in my life. And we still have lots of friends there. Been to three weddings there in the past few years and have lots of friends in Spain.
Wow. I lived in Malaga, Spain, and I've gone to like three ferias, and I love it. I love it a lot. I love
Did you ever eat at Antonio Martín, the great restaurant? Yeah. See, there you go.
Yes.
Antonio Martín.
Oh, it's great.
Antonio Martín. And look at Jeffrey. Look, Jeffrey, what a life you've lived.
Oh, he's.
I mean,
so
I'm jealous just listening to it.
He's living it up. Jeff, how did you? I know you studied acting when you were younger. How did you turn it into becoming a film critic?
I never wanted to be an actor, but my brother,
and
one
you
of my
studied with Lee Strasberg.
Well, my brother and Lee set up the Lee Strasberg Theater Institute, not Actor Studio, where you have to be serious and audition. But Sissy Spacek went there, so some people went from there to the studio. And my brother said, it'll be great for whatever you do. If you told me tomorrow I'm going to speak in front of 5,000 people, I probably would not be as nervous as the person who didn't study acting. And it's also a credential if you're going to be a film critic that you know something about what good acting and bad acting is. And I've seen my father used to see tell me when I'd go with him to a Broadway play. My father was a Broadway columnist, and the actress would cry. My father would turn to me and said, "Look, real tears." In other words, with some actors, it's a device, it's a trick. But I went to Channel 11 after law. Went to law school, and after that, I went to Channel 11, and they were looking for a film critic.
Yeah, PIX 11.
I got the job, and I became the theater critic as well. I was there 18 years.
And the heyday of television, too. News.
Yeah, 21 years, and then went to CBS Radio, where I'm still heard.
I heard you the other day.
I hope it was okay. 15,000 movies and counting, 15 or 16,000 movies, which is ridiculous. But it's all changed now because of the pandemic. I no longer have to schlep to screenings. Because they send me
online,
maybe forever, you know, the way they show movies to critics online now.
So what do you think about the release on Netflix? Apparently, you know, that deal that happened over the weekend regarding Netflix, how they're going to be releasing all their movies. One, I don't know what the details was, but I don't remember exactly. But what do you think about everything coming inside the home?
It's a great time to be an actor because there are so many different venues for your projects. Hulu and Netflix and Acorn and all these different that never existed before. And I think it's good. And there's no alternative anymore. If you're a producer, if you're a studio, do you want to pay to rent to show critics a screening room and all that?
And
rent the big, I will miss if it's the case that movie theaters become a thing of the past, I will miss the camaraderie. I saw The Exorcist in a screening room, but there were other critics there rather than seeing it at home where you can stop and leave the room and come back again.
Right.
There's camaraderie in a theater, but that may be gone. We don't know yet.
Jeffrey, was
it'll come back?
I hope so.
Back in the day, was it always a screening room, or did you sometimes just you paid your $3, $4, $5 and you went to the theater?
They charge for movies. I didn't know that.
you never pay, right?
No,
God, that's one of the perks for him.
But the night before I became a critic, my dad and I had dinner with Ruth Gordon, Academy Award winner for Where's Papa. and she was from Quincy, Mass. And she said, Sonny, you're starting your career tomorrow. Think twice before you're on somebody else's work. And I've always tried to do that. There are several ways for a movie to screen, either at a critic screening in the old sense before the pandemic, or online, or they send me a DVD. So now it's basically all online now.
All right, so let's get into it. I sent Jeffrey a text. I said, listen, when you're on with us, I'm very curious to hear, Jeffrey, your favorite top 10 movies of all time. And you wrote me the list, and I got the all the covers for them so I could go along with you. But I'll give us a quick, real quick, you know, go through them and give me like a 10 seconds. Give us a 10 seconds of why.
Well, I don't have, like, why don't you say the name? Because I don't have the exact list I sent you, but when I got to hear that you were going to ask me about that, I ran over and made a list, but it may not be exactly what you have. So why don't you tell me what I gave you last night? This is an ever
so interest, you know. So I'll put it up and you tell me why this, I think this Graduate was one of your top.
It's my favorite film. It was like, never been in therapy. Closest I've ever come to it. Dustin Hoffman knows that it's my favorite film.
And Mike Nichols is the director.
Joe Levine lived in Mike Nichols lived upstairs from my parents. And when it opened, I put the note under his door saying, you've made the best film of my life. And Mike Nichols and Joe Levine, the producer, sent me a 35 millimeter print of the movie. I didn't have a 35 millimeter projector, but I had the movie. It just changed my life. But that's the number one. I don't want to see it enough. I don't want to read the spontaneity of it. It came at a very, very opportune time in my life.
How about this one right here, The Big Country?
Co-produced by Gregory Peck. And it's one of the great westerns in 1958. He plays a dude from the East. He's come to marry the daughter, Carol Baker, the daughter of a rancher. And he's in the middle of a rain field. Gene Simmons is in the middle. And Chuck Connors is great. And Burl Ives won the Oscar for supporting actor. It's got the most beautiful score of any western I've ever heard.
And by the way, see, Charlton Heston was in the movie, too.
He was in it, so absolutely.
Supporting actor. All right. Here we go. How about this one, Shane?
Oh, I've seen this, Shane.
When he says to young Brandon DeWilla, some guys wear two guns, but one is good enough. If that's all you need. And Ben Johnson is in it, and Van Heflin, and Dean Arthur, and it's just a great, great, timeless film. It's a gorgeous looking film too. George Stevens directed. Just a great film.
A gunfight at the OK Corral.
Anytime Kirk Douglas worked with Burt Lancaster, I was there. Kirk Douglas was a good friend of mine. I loved Isto Danielovich, which was his real name. And it's got the Frankie Lane, I think it's Frankie Lane singing the theme song. And they are great together. Kirk Douglas is Doc Holliday. And he said he had to pace when he coughed. I couldn't do it all the time because, you know, he almost does an imitation of Kirk Douglas. And Burt Lancaster is right up. And Rhonda Fleming, rest in peace, died. Late last year was in it, that 90-something, she died. She's the love interest. And very few people are still alive. Earl Holliman was in the movie. He's still with us. It's just a great film. I love that film.
Wow. All right, how about this one?
When I walk my dog, I sing that. I whistle to Gunfight at OK Corral. 7 Days in May, directed by John Frankenheimer, again with Kirk Douglas and Burt Lancaster. Lancaster plays, it's a Cold War thriller. It's about a coup to take over the government. That sounds familiar. And he's the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and is the one man in his orbit who is loyal to the president, Frederick March. There is Kirk Douglas, who is his Marine Corps aide de camp, and Ava Gardner is in it, and it's just Andrew Duggan is in it, and it's just a wonderful Cold War thriller, and relevant today too, by the way.
Yep. All right, we'll bang through a couple more. Here you go, Manchurian Candidate.
Frank Sinatra, who was a one-take actor, in the most pivotal moment of the movie, when Lawrence Harvey at the right, who played the son of Angela Lansbury, who was only 7 years older than Lawrence Harvey, by the way, and that's Janet Leigh. Lawrence Harvey plays an assassin who can be hypnotized when he sees a certain card in the deck, and they filmed it and it was out of focus. And by the time they realized that, Sinatra would not do another take and left, and it's better that way because his mind was kind of foggy and out of focus. It's one of the great thrillers ever made.
Love it. And this was one of my dad's favorite right here.
My father pushed the plunger that blew up the bridge in the movie, not in real life. He was on the set where they had brought the French chef, and they from Hollywood and William Holden. And Alec Guinness once told me that he almost turned it down. And they didn't sing the lyrics from Colonel Bogey because the lyrics are dirty. They whistled them.
Yeah.
And, it has something to do with Hitler's anatomy. Let's just say that. And Cecil Power was nominated for Best Supporting Actor. And ironically, Red Buttons, Aaron Kwok by birth, Red Buttons won the Oscar for Supporting Actor. And he was sitting right in front of Sesu Hayakawa. And before Red Buttons could get up, Sesu Hayakawa leaned over and pushed his shoulders down and said, "Tonight you die, Yankee dog." It's a great, great.
I remember Hess Gasoline used that, the whistling song, yeah. Right?
My cousin wrote the lyrics to a famous Broadway musical. And when I hear them singing the new words to tradition, it's something. When I hear it in commercials, I'm happy for Cousin Sheldon, but it's not when I want to think of Fiddler on the Roof.
Cousin Sheldon's making money every time it happens, Jeff.
We could have invested in it. It sounded like 2 weeks in the Yiddish theater. That's open in Japan. The theater manager, the foreign interpreter said, "Mr. Harnick, this show is so Japanese, I don't think it'll travel." So,
here you go, Jeffrey. Last one. Here you go. Little Field of Dreams.
This film of the 80s. Only mistake, as you know, Shoeless Joe Jackson was not a right-handed batter. He was a left-handed batter. And James Earl Jones had never been to a baseball game, but he's in this one. He's in When It Was a Game. I remember having Catch with my dad and all that. And I sat next, before the movie, I sat next to James Earl. And he said, I'm not dropping names, it just was fortuitous. And he said, baseball is zen. I don't know what he was talking about. At the end of the movie, when he's having a catch with his dad, and I thought of my dad, tears were in my eyes, and he looked, "See what I mean? Baseball is zen." And it's a great film. And Matt Damon is an uncredited extra in that movie in the scene where they're at Fenway Park, by the way.
Yes.
Wow. Yeah.
Fellow Red Sox fan.
All right. And listen, Jeff, give me your true thoughts on Slapshot. I know you love that movie.
First of all, I'm not the biggest hockey fan in the world. If you take out the words you can't say on TV or radio, you've got a 3-minute script. That's what I thought. Lazily written, but I'm happy for it. And Paul Newman's always a great person to watch.
Yeah, he was great there. He was great. All right, listen, are you now, while we're on the movie topic, are you ready to play this game with Suki?
I'm sure.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a card with a picture on it, which signifies the name of a movie. You just have to look at it. And it'll come to you once you look at. So, for example, I just happen to have this one up. If I give you this one, what's that?
Bridge on the River Kwai.
Right. Very easy. So that's the answer right there. So you got the hang of this, Jeff.
That easy?
Yes.
No, they're not all that easy, but some of them are okay. All right, Suk, you ready? Suk, he's going to be good at this.
Of course he is.
Here is movie number one.
iRobot.
Nicely done. iRobot is the answer.
Should have known that.
How about this one right here?
Singing in the Rain.
Not singing, no G on the end, Singing in the Rain.
Thank you, Jeffrey. Yes, sir.
Gene Kelly had the flu that day that he sang the title number, by the way.
All right, how about this one? You ready? This one's a little tougher. You got to look at it. Just look at it all.
I know Gene Mingo's an old field goal kicker for the Buffalo Bills, but that's all I know.
You got to kind of look at the word in the middle and then...
On with the Wind.
No, put the ends together.
The ends together.
So look at the middle word and then squeeze everything else together.
Gone in 1 minute? I don't know.
You're very close, Jeffrey. What's the name of the movie?
I
don't know.
It's... Gone in 60 seconds.
Gone in 60 seconds.
Right. Okay.
So it's gone in the middle.
Right. I thought it was a night chart. Okay.
All right. How about this one right here?
Brother, brother.
Suk would be a little too easy if that was the answer.
Brother, where art thou?
No. Look at the color. Look at the color of the lettering.
Blue brother, where are you? I don't know.
You're right there, Jeffrey. You're right there.
Blues Brothers.
Ah, Suki, way to go. There you go. All right, couple more to go. Here's, this is the last one. If you did this one, you should get in 5 seconds.
Oh, Three Men and a Baby.
It's too easy. It's just that on Jeopardy the other night, they couldn't identify James Garner, right? I felt superior for 1 minute. And the next question was the periodic table and was put back in my place.
Jeffrey, you've met so many actors, and obviously you mentioned a few that you that really meant a lot to you in the movies when you watched them and you had relationships with.
Yeah.
But some of the people that you would put in your pantheon of, let's say, 10 favorite actors, 10 favorite actresses, can you just shoot them out?
Gene Hackman's my favorite living actor. Dinner at Eight and David Copperfield. And I love being with her. But one night, my parents threw a party for Ethel Barrymore. And I woke up, I was 5 years old, and I went into the living room and I looked around. I didn't recognize any of these people except cowering in fear in the corner was Joseph Paul DiMaggio. So I walked up to him and I pulled his coat and I said, Mr. DiMaggio, you're the best guest here. And 35 years later at an Alzheimer's game, he called me over. I was thrilled that he recognized me. And he said, would you still say that? And I said, I would. In the interim, I learned who I gave the cold shoulder to. In our living room, Ernest Hemingway, Adlai Stevenson, Edward G. Robinson, Comden and Green, and I forget who else, none of whom could hit a curveball. So,
DiMaggio could, though. I love it. Jeff, listen,
my dad's best friend was Orson Welles. His daughter and I are friends. And I think Orson was the world's greatest authority on everything. He and Dr. and Irwin Corey, but that's another story. But Orson was the world's greatest authority, everything except sports. He was going to run for Senate and decided not to, and Joe McCarthy was the opponent, so he might have beaten him.
Jeez, what kind of life did you need to write? Well,
when I was 11, Sophia Loren cooked me a spaghetti dinner in Spain, and I went back to high school. I started a Sophia Loren fan club, and I wouldn't let anybody else join. And I finally introduced her to my wife and my, at that time, 3-year-old son, and she wanted to hold him. And she had 7 miscarriages before she had her sons, and my son was squirrely that day, and he said, no, I want mommy, I want to stay with you. My wife said, Ben, Miss Lauren's the most beautiful woman in the world. No, mommy, you are. She turned to Sophia Loren and said, Lauren, when he's 21 and he wants the keys to the car, I want to remember this moment.
Can I tell you, have you seen that movie on Netflix, What Would Sophia Loren Do?
Yes, she was wonderful.
Oh, it was wonderful. I thought it was
a remake of Madame Rosa. She's just magnificent. She's just an amazing lady. And my father was the first American journalist to meet her. It was on the set of The Pride and the Passion. That's where I met her. And he warned her about the intrusive questions she was going to face, no doubt, when she came to America for the first time, about her marriage to a man who was 20 years older and half a foot shorter. Mm-hmm. And she never forgot that. And when the next movie came, she did Legends of the Lost with John Wayne in the Libyan desert. And she didn't bring any warm pajamas, not thinking that the desert was freezing at night. And my father lent her an extra pair of woolen pajamas. And when she came back to New York, she had them all ironed and perfectly set and all that. So there was a relationship between them two. So I have space in my heart for Sophia.
Jeffrey, listen, my friend, thank you so much for taking some time today. I mean, we could listen to these stories all night.
Suki, I was on, I think I was at Pix with you one night. I was a guest one night. I enjoyed working with both
of you. For two books. I think you came on for two of your books, actually. And we did a couple of Oscar recaps and all those kind of things together. What do you think about the Oscars this year? I mean, what do you think? How do you think it's going to go and everything like that?
I think they'll have no choice but to make it virtual. I mean, I really do. I hope they do because I don't want to get anybody sick. By that time, April, I don't know that it's going to be right. It's going to be virtual, so to speak. I think it's a shame, but maybe next year it'll be better.
I hope so. Jeffrey, you are incredible. You are
Jeffrey,
awesome.
Thank you, my friend.
I can hear these stories. I wish we were friends early on in life because I would have loved to have been in Spain with him, hanging out with these people. I mean, like, holy crap. Your best friend, Jeffrey, must have had an amazing life.
Next thing you're going to say is it's not you, it's me.
Jeffrey, thank you, my man. Keep going, and we love you, pal.
Anytime.
The great thank Jeffrey you, Lyon, everybody.
Take care,
the
my
great
friend.
Jeffrey Lyons.
Wow, Sue. He really did have an amazing life, no?
Can I tell you something? Did you hear those stories?
Well, let's see. He was hanging out
summering in Spain with Hemingway.
Ernest Hemingway and Sophia. A little pasta with Sophia Loren. I had pasta with Vinny DiVincenzo down the street last week, if that means anything to you.
Listen, you're a little out of sync. I don't know why it's like a little, keep talking really quick.
I'm out of sync.
You're freezing.
I look like I'm,
for the first time in a long time.
I look like I'm perfectly in sync.
You're frozen.
I'm frozen? Still? Can you hear me? Am I still frozen? I don't look frozen.
You're frozen and you're kind of like not.
I think it's you. It's not
really?
Me. It's you, Suki. Yeah. I'm going to look real quick before we get Tony Hills in the house. He's standing by. Am I still freezing with you?
Kind of like. No, you're perfect.
I think it's you. It's not really?
Yeah. See it? See, we're there.
Yeah. I'm going to look real quick before we get Tony Hills in the house.
Can you hear it?
Standing by. Am I still freezing
with you? I hear everything on delay right now.
No, you're on delay because I'm playing it off my phone.
Oh,
I'm playing you the video on my phone to show you that we're not frozen.
I was like, this thing is going off the rails because I'm hearing lots of things right now. I'm just gonna
Suk, listen, okay. Tony Hill's coming up in just a few minutes. This guy is like the ultimate fitness guru. He's got some new projects, some new companies he's working with. And by the way, the guy has the voice of an angel. So we're going to, we'll prod him a little bit, Suk. We'll get him to sing for us a little bit. But first, listen, snow on the East Coast like you wouldn't believe. This is my backyard right here. As of earlier today, I got 75 inches of snow. And I think we should check in with the weatherman, Suk. Let's check it out. David G.
And now it's time for the Suki and Scott Show Traffic and Weather with David G, the weatherman.
That's me, David G. Still COVID-free. Thanks, guys. Great to be back on the Suki and Scott Traffic and Weather set with all the amenities. And speaking of amenities, our retractable dome roof is frozen in the open position, hence the snow blowing in. And as we speak, our wonderful staff is trying to get that problem solved. Before we get to our traffic and weather together, I would like to take this opportunity to thank my pal, the wonderful Mr. Scott Stanford, for always being there for me after I was blown up, shot up, torched up, and burnt up. Scotty would always show up at the hospital to take me home. Love you, buddy. Okay, let's get right to our traffic. Although we've been advised to stay off the roads, some of you just can't. This video sent in by Suki and Scott's cellmate, Buttons Cowens. You'll want to stay away from Route 9W in Pomona. Crews are trying to clean up the right lane after this fender bender. Also, stay away from Sloatsburg, New York. We have a multi-car pileup over there. The insurance companies are already on the scene. And please, folks, make sure you fasten your car before getting out or you'll end up like this well-dressed moron over in Queens. I'm sure his wife will not be happy tonight. And finally, if you're expecting your kids home from school, don't worry. Our drivers are doing everything possible to make sure they get home safe and on time. And now, our Suki and Scott weather? Well, you know the weather. It's cold and it sucks. Check your phone if you want more. During the storm yesterday, I had a chance to catch up on some of my opera voice lessons. And I'd love to end the segment and sing myself out with this little number.
Ave Maria.
So let me ask you a question. What were you helping him with?
Suk, every time the guy gets injured, you know, all for the last month, every
doing?
Time he tries to get the traffic and whether he gets injured, I got to go pick him up. Somebody got to pick him up at the hospital. Suki, this yobo is amazing. It really feels good. I'm vibrating myself all over the place. You got yours? Yeah, you like it, right? You like it. We're going to talk about these after Tony Hill is in. because after we get done with Tony, we're going to be sore and we're going to need some of these power tools.
Oh, my God, this is awesome. I feel so good right now.
Yeah. Folks, we're going to tell you about these in just a little bit.
Incredible.
And how you can get a nice little free shipping deal when you mention it. I always wanted our own promo code, Souk. Now we finally have one, and we're going to tell you how you can get it in just a few minutes. But first, ladies and gentlemen, Tony Hill's in the house. Let me show you Tony.
I need like a jackhammer for most of my muscles, so this feels incredible.
You keep jackhammering yourself there for a second, and I'm going to let's bring Tony in after that.
DK 500 Volume 2 is like double your pleasure, double your fun.
Double your fun.
Six.
Got it, sure.
Five.
Chucky's gonna mend it. Chucky's gonna mend it. Good one, that was it. Woo!
Senora. Four, three, two, right side. I used to think that I could not go.
The kingdom's gonna check your souls.
And life was nothing but an awful thing.
They call it Peter's chicken.
But now I know the meaning of true love.
Sounds good, right?
That was really good. Tony Hill,
what's up? See the gun show, baby.
I see the guns. Man. Highly impressive. So nice to have you here.
You too. It's good to see you guys, man. I heard some really wonderful things about you. Hey, you know that video you saw?
Yes.
That was my wife next to me, actually. Yeah. She's in her 50s. Can you believe that?
Wow. Fantastic.
Two boys, yeah. I just turned 61.
Two boys.
Yeah,
married for how long?
I just turned 61, yes.
Tony, you're 61?
Yes, sir.
Jesus Louise. That's listen.
I can't believe
it. I say we skip right past the working out and go to and you just sing.
You're frozen, Scotty, and your face is like this.
No, but Tony, am I frozen to you? Am I frozen?
No, you're right on to me.
Souk,
right
that's on. Just Souk, it's your computer, I
so
think.
So let's talk about you, Tony.
Yeah, oh, okay. See, Souk, I hear it coming out of your computer late. Souk, sign off for a second and come back in. Yeah, okay. Tony, we'll get her back in a second, yeah, man. Yeah, but I'm not frozen to you, right?
No, you clean.
Yeah, no, that's got to be her deal. But listen, man, hold on. Here, she's back. Souk, you back?
Yes, Tony, I'm back.
Yeah, oh, yeah. There you go. Yes. So, Tony, listen, 61. You are in impeccably good shape and you got all these new things going. Tell us first about this Fit Music Media. Because this is like this is a beautiful thing where you guys basically, you got this music that just jacks people up and gets them going, right?
Exactly. So the thing behind it is that, you know, I've been doing this for a long time, over 30 years. So most people take music to movement. So you listening to the music, you're moving, but you have no mission. So what I've actually done with the music is divided into phrases and bars, okay, and 32 beats, okay? So instead of me using the musicology of how music is, a phrase and bars, I says, okay, let me take the 32 beats and say 32 reps.
Oh, wow.
So when I'm listening, I got a producer that creates a bass line. That bass line is divided into 32 beats or beats per minute.
Yeah.
So you go, when you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, that's 4 sets of 8 reps, which is 32 repetitions per exercise. So what's happening, you're actually doing at the end of one exercise over 200 repetitions of the exercise. You have no idea because the music is carrying you. And then my instructors are actually not only instructors, but they're MCs at the same time. So they're educated MCs because they know about muscle movement. They understand how long it takes for the muscle to be activated before it gets into what is called the visceral fat, which is the stubborn fat. The stubborn fat is what we want to get rid of. We just don't want to sweat. We actually want to look fantastic. And these people that you see in this video here worked with me for 7 months to prepare for this video. They were all overweight.
Wow, they were all overweight in this video? Yeah.
Yes, and they were all overweight. I was in Turkey at the time. Teaching in Turkey. I've taught in Amsterdam and in a lot of other places. Yeah, this system. So we just moved back into America in 2016, and EOS actually is giving them a plug. They actually believed in my system, and now it's just going bananas right now. So I'm really excited. So Fit Music Media primarily was started behind me giving beat makers a job. So instead of them getting paid for like work for hire, I take a beat maker that has all these beats he never sell. I said, send him to FMM. And what I do is I tell him to reformat them, and I pay him a 3-5% royalty throughout the life of the music he sells. Instead of being paid one time, he's part of the company and he's part of the team. And now he's got a career instead of 3 or 4 jobs, and he's making beats at the same time.
Wow.
That's amazing.
That's awesome.
They're creating those beats for people to inspire them to work out, right?
Exactly. So FMM then controls the licensing and everything. So I actually control everything in the music. So you don't have to worry about the bureaucracy, and the music that's made by the company is actually designed to, it's equipment. It is not just music that sounds good. It's literally equipment. So what I do with the people who purchase the music, I demonstrate the movements with the music they purchase.
Oh, wow. And a lot of people are chiming in, Tony. Yes. They saw some of the moves. I mean, obviously, a lot of the moves were advanced. So, you know, we have people of all different ranges on our chain right now. Yes. And so a couple of them are like, oh, my back couldn't handle that and stuff like that. So obviously you must have a range of fitness to work up to that level, right?
Well, yes. What the beautiful thing about Touche is actually the system that works with FMM. Touche is both my companies. Tough, outrageously unique, challenging, highly motivated exercise. Hmm. It's part of I was a military person for 9 years. I served my country, and 14 years I was in law enforcement. So see, for what I did was, I'm the real deal. I was a platoon sergeant.
You were like, two more.
Get in the dirt. So hey, the music, here's the music. The music is like the drill sergeant without the profanity.
wait, Tony, please tell me once in your military career, you looked at somebody square in the eye and you said, what is your major malfunction, numbnuts?
Well, I didn't say that, but I did say, what's your major malfunction?
Oh, that's great. You really did say that?
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah, that's great.
Ah, what a great movie.
So what happens is with the fitness, I understand that everyone has a fitness level, a different fitness level. So the beauty of Touche and the music that goes with it is I show you how to work up to completing the things you say you can't do. So I make what was impossible now possible. So when you do reach your goal, you're already looking fantastic through the struggle. So we struggle together. So we have a combination of exercise and mentorship, because if you could do it on your own, you wouldn't need anything else. Yeah,
right.
So and all I did was just add that little insight.
And folks can join on with you virtually right now.
Actually, you can go to touchefitness.com, or you can go to TKFitTV, or you can go to fitmusicmedia.com, and you can reach me anywhere. We have workshops, we have courses, we have classes in the park. Because of COVID and social distancing, I do a lot of stuff in the park. And now that I'm in a health club, what happens is all my classes are full. So that's a problem, because they can only handle like 20.
Okay. There's Fit Music Media right across the bottom there.
FitMusicMedia.com, that's for the music. ToucheFitness.com, that's for all the workshops and the certifications. In Fit Music Media, also for beat makers out there, if you really want to make a living, You go there, you fill out that form, you send us some sample music. If my team actually loves you, we will actually market you as an individual, brand you, and we do a global, I have a global release. 80% of my income is actually Europe.
Wow.
That's my audience right there. I'm just now.
What's the Touché website again?
ToucheFitness.com.
Listen, Tony, so I got to imagine COVID's kind of changed the whole fitness industry on its, you know, on its heels a little bit. How it looks like you've already been in this position to transition people to at home fitness workouts. It sounds like it.
Well, yeah. Can I give you my beginning story? Here's what it is. As an athlete growing up, you know, I was in ROTC, you know, I was in the Boy Scouts, and, you know, I love to be active, right? So what happened was I just got out of the military and I was looking for a career, and I actually found a company that just started out, International Sports and Science Association, ISSA. It was absolutely amazing. They were simple and nobody really knew them, so I jumped off into that. And it started by a guy named Hatfield, Fred Hatfield, which is called Dr. Squat. He was the first to squat, I think, approximately 700 pounds, right? He had a conviction in his heart to help people, to help them understand how to transition from a cultural lifestyle to a healthy lifestyle. Because, you know, culture is what takes our lives early. Because if you like a certain amount of food, this food may be good for your culture, but it may be not be for your long life because you'll suffer the same injuries. So with ISSA, as I begin to walk with that company, and I worked with that company certifying instructors for approximately 5 years with Tom Platz. I mean, a fantastic guy, right? He was inducted in the Bodybuilding Hall of Fame with Arnold Schwarzenegger. And I met Arnold and I met, you know, it's just a great thing for me. And so as I got this system that was, you know, encouraged and threw on me, right? I go, wait a minute, how do I really help people to change? So I wasn't even thinking about COVID or nothing. I always believed that if you actually are cellularly healthy, God designed your body to fight anything. And that's the truth. Nobody will tell you that. So if you inject yourself, now I'm not, you know, I'm not political. I just tell people the truth.
Right.
If you inject yourself with a foreign substance, your body's not going to accept that. So you have to manufacture something that looks like something so the body can replicate it and fight it, but it's not honest. It's going to kill you anyway. So why not take what you have, learn about it, move your body, understand it, and then you're ready for anything, whether it's COVID, whether it's a new virus, because viruses are like humans. They mutate because they don't want to die. That's just the way they are. They're like bullies. They say, you can kill my brother, but you're not going to kill me. You know, and they just grow and change, right? Mm-hmm. So what I was already prepared, you know, for this transition, because all I teach people, even in my classes, is listen, we're going to walk through this together. I'm going to work with you. We're going to make it. We're going to make it happen. You and me together. My heaviest client was over 500 pounds.
Wow.
And I tell you, it touched me because the beauty of it was when we walked down the street one block, it was amazing for her because she could not even walk that far. And so we turned one block into two blocks, into three blocks. And then she began to get control over her self-confidence and she was encouraged. And then she just moved into a lifestyle she never thought she could do, but I was holding her hand. I was walking with her. I was listening to her. I always tell people, women are the hardest to convince. They're the hardest to convince. And if you don't get into their mind and tell them what they're doing and how they're doing it and why they're doing it, you can forget it. They'll hang in there for a few days or whatever, but they'll look at you and say, look, you know what? Give me my food over there. I'm leaving this alone for now. You know what I mean? So women have taught me a whole lot. You know, Karen, you know, we've been working together for 24 years.
And married how many?
24 years.
Wow.
24.
And the boys and your children are how old?
I have a daughter that's actually 40.
Wow.
And I have a son that's 22 and a son that's 19.
Wait, yeah. Tony, show me again. Keep me motivated a little bit. Let me see what you got. Oh,
wow.
61 years old, Sue.
Unbelievable.
61 years old.
Unbelievable.
Tony, what do you eat when you wake up? What do you eat for breakfast?
Well, hey, but you know what? I'm going to tell you this. Can you do it? Yes, you can, because it's simple. Let me tell you. I get up in the morning. I have what is called, I make me a concoction. It's called Green Vibrance, right? It's equivalent to about 5 pounds of greens. I put it, one scoop, put water in there, put a high volume zinc, magnesium powder, or vitamin C. I put that in, I mix it up. It's gross. I drink it because I know it's going to work. So I close my eyes and don't breathe through my mouth. And I hope I don't get any on my shirt because it'll change the color of my shirt. So I drink it. So once that's gone, then I have a dragon fruit.
I love dragon fruit.
What's a dragon fruit?
That dragon
beautiful fruit. Little, it's a beautiful fruit. It looks like a little dragon, but inside it's all white with like little dots.
Okay, I'm going to get one for you so you can actually see it. But inside the dragon fruit, it's the ugliest fruit ever, okay? But inside, it is packed with antioxidants and the things that help increase your immune system by 100-fold. It's absolutely amazing. It looks kind of like that.
It's a pretty color. What's wrong with you, Tony? It's a magenta.
But look at it. It's the ugliest kind of thing ever.
It looks like there's a prehistoric thing.
Exactly.
In there.
Exactly. Right? And this is white meat inside. They have one with dark red, and then they have the sweetest, which is actually yellow, and it's incredibly sweet, but it's so good for you. And then after that, I train, and then I go into my food, which then I start having, like today I had sweet potato pancakes, and I had an omelet, and I had some potatoes, right? And so then I just had another meal, which I had tuna. I had tuna, and then I had these chips that are really healthy. They some kind of flour that doesn't hurt you. It's very vegan and natural. And so, and then I have an energy drink that's packed with things that I like CoQ10, things like that to keep my body and my energy up. So I'm usually up around 5:30 or 6 o'clock every morning.
Wow. It's amazing. Oh, I'm sorry. What did you say? You wanted to sing? I thought I heard you say that. I thought I heard you say you wanted to sing. And by the way, I'm feeling, what am I feeling, Ty? I'm feeling like a little Stevie Wonder-ish for you. That's what I'm feeling.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, do you want music or without music?
However you want to do it. However you want to do it. Feel better doing it.
What did I do with my thing? Hold up. Huh? Drop it. Wait a minute. Hold up. Newsflash. Wait a minute. Because I had it here. Okay. This song that I'm going to do for you. It's a very wonderful song, one of my favorites. It's called Love's in Need, right? I don't want to sing the whole thing. You just want me to sing a little bit, right?
You sing as much as you
want. He likes to hear people sing.
Yeah, I like to just hear. If you could sing, I like to hear you sing.
Okay, let me see if I can get it. Good morning, evening, friends. Here's your friendly announcer. I have serious news to pass on to everybody, yeah, what I'm about to say, hey, could mean the world disaster, could change your joy and laughter to tears and pain. Is that love's in need? Of love today. Don't delay. Send yours in right away. Hey. Going round. Breaking many hearts. Stop it, please. Before it's gone too far, oh, hey. All right.
Woo! They wanted to hear more, Tony. Come on.
Tony, you know what my favorite Stevie song is? I used to sing to Suki at 5 o'clock in the morning in the makeup room. I used to have her put it on. It was I'm a man of many wishes.
Oh,
premonitions.
Now that's
what
good
I really feel.
And then you look at Suki and you want, and she makes you want to go, isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful?
Woo! Listen, Tony, can I ask you a question? Are you and your wife like the yin and the yang, like the way you approach fitness and also how you approach your clients in terms of really connecting with them to get them to their goals?
Yes, and that's a really good point. One of the things too is giving her honor because she is just an amazing mom, an amazing person, you know, in what she does. What she does actually is that she helps you at a cellular level. So when you talk to her, usually she gets people with thyroidism. She gets people with rheumatoid arthritis, cancer. She gets people that have eating disorders. Wow. She works with families. This is one story that I want to tell you. It's a young lady. This couple actually has a young son. He's a teenager, and he had multiple tumors throughout his body, all cancerous, and they could never really figure it out. So all Karen did was, number one, is she listened, and number two, she didn't judge. Number three, she just gave them basic stuff, just stuff to help them. But the thing that really that changed her son's life was that she held them accountable. And once they know you're there, it changes their whole world. And so she knows, she's a research addict. So she searches. I mean, she did her internship, you know, at the United Nations. I mean, she was a political science major, you know, going to school in New York. And she got out and she went back to school to get her nutrition stuff because she totally changed. When she saw the UN, she says, I'm out of here. I'm going to teach people how to eat. So when she does that, she sets the foundation for me to come in. And then I teach them how to exercise the mechanics and teach them how to eat for the rest of their life, which is the most important thing. Because you can't use the word diet for the rest of your life. It does not mean reduction in calories. It means food. It means eat. You got to eat to live.
You got to eat. Tony, listen, man, it was an absolute pleasure to have you on, buddy.
Yes.
FitnessMedia.com, ToucheFitness.com.
And then you can go to tkfit.expert. Also, tkfit.expert, we're going to be doing a medley of education. You'd be able to meet with both of us, Karen and I, on tkfit.expert is what that is.
.expert.
Yes. And on touchefitness.com, I'm actually, every Friday, I'm doing Ask Tony.
Oh, wow.
So you can actually go into that Zoom. And it's free.
Oh, wow. Wonderful.
And spend one hour with me. It's called Just Ask Tony. And you can actually, literally, I'm there. And you can ask me whatever you like. And I'm there for you.
Oh.
I got to get those arms like that.
Hey, Scott, I got you, man. I got you.
Tony, you might see me on there. I'll be.
I got you. Oh, and you guys know, I just wanted to say one thing though. This book, I have a book called, it's called Bodybuilding is Not Weightlifting. See that?
Okay.
You can get that on touchefitness.com. It's in two languages, one English, one Turkish. And it has a workout. That workout DVD you saw is in
this
book. That's
interesting. Bodybuilding is not weightlifting.
Exactly. It's an easy read. See, Scott. But I don't really, unless photos and pictures, I don't like to read. See how thin that is?
I need diagrams, Tony.
And then this one right here is we're getting ready to release it. This is everything in over 30 years of experience.
Wow. Exercises
and food, right?
Wow.
We had this translated into English. So this is a book that's out there as well.
Love it. Love it. Tony, okay. Thank you so much.
Congratulations, Tony.
Love to have
your
back,
wife,
my man.
Beautiful wife too, and your family. Thank you so much for taking time with us tonight.
And can I do a shout out?
Yeah,
absolutely.
Special shout out to Tracy Harper.
Tracy, we love Tracy.
Yeah, I've been knowing Tracy for almost 20 years.
Tracy,
and
is the
also special shout out to my team. You know, Ariel Shaw from Shaw Consulting. You know, and my really good friend and brother, Prodigal Son from the Wu-Tang Clan, Sons of Man.
Yeah.
Wow. You know, I gotta say shout out. Yeah.
Ah, you got
power,
it.
Yeah.
You went there, man. All right.
You know I'm gonna have to go there. That's my boy. You know?
I love it. Stay low and sanitized,
my friend. Low and sanitized.
Yes, sir.
Tony, so, thank you, buddy.
I look forward to seeing you guys again.
Asking my love to your wife.
Yes.
Good luck. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Good looking. So smart.
Inspirational. Wow. Wait, did you
love that.
Did you say good looking?
Oh, look who's back. Look at you.
First of all, listen, Tony, amazing. The guy's inspirational. I started my diet like a month ago and working out. I'm gonna log on to his stuff. I want to try and do that.
I'm doing my yoga right now.
Suk, you yoboing? Phil, we got to tell you about this new product that Suki and I have.
A yobo, huh?
Well, you're going to get one of these.
Oh, Phil, you're going to get one of these. It's called the yobo.
Nice.
It's unbelievable. It's like this. Hold on. It's one of those massage guns, but it's a mini, right? It's a little mini massage gun.
Yeah.
And you basically, Phil, it basically massages every part of your body.
But it targets, like I like this one because I have very tight shoulders.
Yeah.
And it kind of targets the areas that feel good. And it, look it at how cute it is.
Nice little box.
It comes in this little case.
Nice little carrying case.
And not only that, it has different attachments.
Yeah, you got different attachments. You know how they have all those massage guns they use at the gyms now to work people out? The trainers use them. This yobo, it's basically your own personal little handheld
massager.
It's this big. It's almost the size of your cell phone. And they come in all kinds. Here's the accessories, Philly kid. Look, you get all those different things that go into the gun. And it's really easy to do. I mean, this thing comes, if they pop out, right? It comes right out.
Yeah.
And you can exchange it with other ones. And you hold it. And you literally, if you have like just a sore neck, right?
People
use it, right? Suk's got the sore neck. You put it on your thighs or any part of your body. Phil, just start singing. I'm going to just sit here like this.
Oh, you too.
Listen, here's the thing. You guys go to theyobo.com, right? It's across the screen, yobo.com. When you go there, if you type in the code Suki and Scott, you get free shipping, right? Because shipping costs a fortune these days. So you get free shipping on every order, yobo.com. You type in the code Suki and Scott. Again, you get them in blue. You can get them in pink. Here's all the different colors. They have six different colors, right? You got black, red, pink, green, blue, and silver. And the carrying case with the four attachments. And it's literally just as powerful as those big massage guns. It really is.
Can I ask you a question? I don't know about you guys, but my husband always is like, oh, babe, he comes home, you know, from work and his neck is hurting.
Yeah.
As you get older and you're working and you have a very physical job, you know, there's like little points where you get these kinks. I don't know about you guys, but you get little kinks. Men, women, you know what I'm talking about. You sit at the computer and all of a sudden you're like, oh, my neck, my shoulder, underneath my shoulder, it all hurts. This thing is like working like a charm and getting all these little kneading my muscles. You know what I mean?
Suk, you know, I had like 5 years ago, I had that car accident where I got hit from behind by two cars and it screwed up my neck. And I got to tell you, this thing makes it feel off. It's awesome. The yobo. And folks, just type in that code, Suki and Scott. We'll show you this again on
nobody's talking to each other. I'm just sitting there like this. I love it.
Yes.
Phil,
I'm going to have to go now because I'm just going to make my husband do this for me.
Yeah, I don't blame you. I don't blame you. Those are awesome.
Suki, don't get too carried away with this thing. Valentine's Day is coming up.
But hey, by the way, Valentine's Day is coming. You know, talk about the gift that keeps giving. This is the gift.
There you go.
That's true. Valentine's Day is coming up. And the other thing is, we're talking about those attachments. You get this guy is crazy, right? It really massages you. Then you got the flat one. Mm-hmm. And you got this little pointy one. Suki, you using the pointy one right now?
I like the pointy one because it goes right into the muscles. Like I have tight shoulder muscles.
It's like a little missile action. It's really great. You know, listen, Suki and I wouldn't steer you in the wrong direction, folks. You got Valentine's Day coming up. And yep. It's a great gift.
Like Scotty, like women who like stand up too long on like your feet and stuff,
yeah, yeah.
Back your calves hurt. These things, it's just like point and shoot. Like,
no, it's
like,
great.
I don't know about you guys, but I haven't, you know, I haven't gone to get a massage in like a year or something like that. You know, mm-hmm. like all the things that you used to maybe get a little gift certificate for, yeah. or for your anniversary or your birthday, all the things that people used to do, they can't do it anymore. You kind of have to do it at home. So this is kind of a great thing to do.
And when you, yeah. Suk, when you put this on like the highest speed, it really jacks you up pretty good.
Bill, you got to get one of these. We're going to get you these for your wife, because I think this is something like you can actually like really knead out like a lot of the kinks that we have from all of the stress that we're dealing with lately.
The thing, it weighs nothing. You hang out on your couch watching TV and you just massage it. It's really cool. I got to tell you, I'm not crazy about a lot of these products.
Yeah, I know.
You know, like when you used to go into like Brookstone or one of those places. Oh, yeah.
No, this is way better.
Yeah, those big jackhammer massagers. But this thing is great. I literally sit watching TV all night when I'm watching Blacklist. But
nice.
Again,
I'm going to get two of those.
If you go to theyobo.com, you type in the code Suki and Scott, you're going to get free shipping. You're going to save yourself a lot of money.
We love it.
Theyobo.com.
Theyobo.com, Phil.
Theyobo.com.
Suki and Scott, and you receive free shipping.
Nice. Again, just a programming note, guys. We're not on tomorrow night. We'll be back on Thursday with Bill Engvall and our guy YX, that singer with the ukulele. Phil and I, another triumphant Suk. People are they're asking for you. We had another triumphant song, almost 100,000 views. Suki, I'll give it to you a little quick. You got to join in on it. We could do threesomes. Why?
Ba 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 ba. I'm sleeping and right in the middle of a good dream. Like all at once I wake up from something that keeps knocking at my brain. But before I go insane, I hold my pillow to my head and spring up in my bed, screaming out the words I dread. I think I love you. I think I love you. This morning I woke up with this feeling I didn't know how to deal with. And so I just decided to myself, I'd hide it to myself and never talk about it. And did not go and shout it when you walked into the room. I think I love you. I think I love you. I think I love you. So what am I so afraid of? I'm afraid that I'm not sure of a love there is no cure for.
I think I love you.
So, Suk, if you get the app, you could do a group.
All right, I'm getting the app.
What we would do is Phil and I would do the duet, and then we send it to you, and then it'll be a
It's that easy.
And then you just sing along with us, and it records it. It's great.
look at Jeannie Clay. You guys sounded great on my Bluetooth speakers.
Oh, forget it. Are you kidding me? It's like award-winning.
Anyway, guys, so I all day long I've been dealing with my son's teachers and report cards, and let's just say things didn't go so well. So yeah. I now need to leave.
You're leave, okay.
Before I go and kill him right now. So I need to he already knows that I'm upset at him. So I'll just try and keep myself calm as I encourage him to do better tomorrow.
Yeah, all right. You got to take care of business. I understand.
Suk, we'll see you on Thursday night, not tomorrow.
All right,
Thursday night, we'll be back.
Good night, Suki. Bye.
Good night, Philly. Good night, love you.
Love you too.
Philly kid.
Yeah. Hey, I got to ask you a serious question here.
Serious? Really?
Yeah. Go back to Tony Hill.
Yes.
That guy is awesome. But I got to ask you, you know, he's a veteran.
Yes, he was a veteran.
He's veteran, he's muscular, and he's bald, and he sings.
Are
you trying to replace me?
Well, Phil, I did mean to, now that you bring it up, I was going to call you into the office.
No, that guy was awesome, man. That guy's awesome.
Yeah, no, he was, my God, did you see the physique on him?
Oh, yeah, man.
Jesus.
Wow.
I tell you, that gives me, you know, he's got me by a few years. So I've been working at it last couple months, and you know, we're going to see if we can keep this thing going.
Yeah. That dude looks like he's 30.
Yeah, no, he definitely does not look 61. But anyway, so Philly, listen, another triumphant weekend for us. Little yes. Partridge family. I think I love you.
Yeah.
And, you know, we'll, so again, some folks not getting the joke of it. Some folks taking us are singing very seriously. Some folks, you know, listen, people, Phil's got his page. The guy's an amazing singer. I swear I'm not trying to get in on his stuff. I swear. It's just us having some fun when we got nothing to do on the weekends. We love you guys.
Hey, man, we're a couple of college kids having a great time singing some songs.
Yeah, that's it. That's it. We've got a new app, and we're having some fun with it. And it's just usually just one or two folks that are like, ah, Phil, drop, get rid of that guy. He sucks. But it's all good. It's all
good. Yeah, man. Yeah.
But so listen, man, you want to – so we have – so we're not on tomorrow night. It's my daughter's 11th birthday tomorrow.
Ah, happy birthday to her. Nice.
You know, I didn't want to work on the show all day, and I wanted to be nice and present for her birthday. So.
Of course, family first.
Absolutely. But listen, man, I am giving you the floor. Three tunes if you want. A little mini Phil concert if you like, my friend.
Yeah, here we go. So I've been I don't really watch the news, but I've been keeping on social media how you guys are getting destroyed by a snowstorm up there.
Oh, Philly, get it. It's unbelievable. So
this first song is dedicated to everybody in your area.
Beautiful.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we got no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping. And I brought me some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. And the fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. But so I'm going to give a shout out to Lee Burke. She's one of my followers, and I told her I'd give her a shout out and sing her. She requested a song. So Lee, I'm going to sing you a little Elvis that you requested.
Which one?
Teddy Bear.
Nice. Oh, I did see somebody ask you for that. Go ahead.
Yeah. Baby, let me be your loving teddy bear. Put a chain around my neck and lead me anywhere. Oh, let me be your teddy bear. I don't want to be your tiger, 'cause tigers play too rough. I don't want to be your lion, 'cause lions ain't the kind you love enough. I just want to be your teddy bear. Put a chain around my neck and lead me anywhere. Oh, let me be your teddy bear. Baby, let me be around you every night. Run your fingers through my hair and cuddle me real tight. Oh, let me be your teddy bear. There you go, Lee. Hope you have a great night.
Let me be your teddy bear.
Yeah.
Phil, you see, I got my new Slapshot poster behind me. It's a very
exciting. That's awesome, man.
It's an exciting day for me. I was very proud of it. Oh, dude, you got to see the Beatles back there?
Yeah.
I'm changing that out for this color canvas that I found from, you know, the movie The Usual Suspects? No, forget it. Reservoir Dogs.
Yes.
Remember Reservoir with Harvey Keitel and those guys?
Oh, yeah.
I got a really nice one. Same shape, horizontal shape as the Beatles back there. It's like a canvas of the guy, all the guys walking.
Yeah.
From Reservoir Dogs. It's real with their, you know, they all had the black skin with the black skinny ties on. Yeah. Love that movie. So yeah, I got to change things up a little bit, you know?
Heck yeah, man. That's I love the Reservoir Dogs. One of my favorite movies of all time.
Really good movie. I like that. Yeah. What else you want to do, my friend?
I'm going to do another Elvis tune. Don't Be Cruel.
Oh, Don't Be Cruel.
Got a lot of requests for that one. You know I can be found sitting home alone. If you can't come around, at least please telephone. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Baby, if I made you mad for something I might have said, please let's forget the past. The future looks bright ahead. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. I don't want no other love. Oh, it's just you I'm thinking of. Let's walk up to the preacher. Let us say I do. Then you're gonna have me, baby. And I'm gonna have you too. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. I don't want no other love. Baby, it's just you I'm thinking of. Don't be cruel.
Nice. Elvis. Somebody wants to know if you could do Dock of the Bay.
Dock of the Bay.
Sitting on the dock of the bay. Wasting time, roll away. You got it up? Go ahead.
Yeah. Sitting in the morning sun. I'll be sitting when the evening comes. Watching the ships roll in. Then I watch them roll away again. Yeah. Sitting on the dock of the bay. Watching the tide roll away. Ooh, I'm just a sitting on the dock of the bay. Wasting time. Well, I left my home in Georgia, headed for the Frisco Bay. 'Cause I've had nothing to live for. Looks like nothing's gonna come my way. So I'm just sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time.
Philly, I got to get you one of these yobos.
I want one. Yeah, I'm gonna
send one to you. You know what? Where this really works on the muscles on your gluteus maximus.
Really?
On your buttocks. Yeah. You know how because you know what happens, and I'm you know, usually I goof around, but I'm not even being funny right now. When you walk around all day or you sit at a desk, you know, your butt takes the brunt of all that action, right?
Sure.
So, you know, if you got something like this and you push it against like all the areas of your butt and it just like works out the stress.
Yeah.
And it really does, you know, it really helps, you know, because you can't rub your butt yourself because that's like washing your own hair. Washing your hair, getting it washed at the salon feels much better, right? When someone, well, I'm sorry, you wouldn't know that, but I mean when someone's scrubbing your hair. But this yobo is really great, and I'm going to send you one. You get free shipping no matter what because you know you're part of the show.
Yeah.
But
nice. So, yeah, I can use it. Yeah, I tell you what, after 40 years in the military and as a cop. my body is pretty much like a junkyard. So
yeah, I can imagine.
I've got pains everywhere. So I love those things.
All right, finish us up, baby. Give us one more, and we'll see everybody back here on Thursday.
Okay, let's do a little "Lady" from Styx. Back from the 70s.
I love that song. Love it.
Lady, when you're with me, I'm smiling. Give me all your love. Your hands, they build me up when I'm sinking. Touch me and my troubles all fade. Now, lady, from the moment I saw you standing, all alone, you gave all the love that I needed. So shy, like a child who is grown. You're my lady. Turn me on when I'm lonely. Show me all your charm. Evenings when you lay down beside me. You're my lady.
Lady, from the moment I saw you, honey. Phil, listen, I want you to think real hard about a good duet we could do this weekend.
Okay.
Because I really feel like I'm in my groove now, and I feel like you and I have been gelling even more, you know, better every weekend.
Cool, yeah. How about something like Ivory and Ivory?
You mean Ebony and Ivory?
I don't know if that would work.
Ivory and Ivory? Well, I'll be Ebony. You could be Ivory.
Okay.
Live together in perfect harmony. We'll come up with a good one.
We'll have a good one.
Finish it off, baby. A little good night, sweetheart.
Whoa, good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go.
Do, 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 do.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go.
Do, 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 do.
We hate to leave you, but we really must say, oh, good night, sweetheart. Good night.
You guys, good night, everybody. We love you.